Be encouraged and live. Live. Come on, live this life. Don't waste your time. That's what I want to talk about just briefly right here. So many believers, especially John 10:10, the thief coming but for to steal, kill, and destroy. But Jesus said, I am come that they might have life and have it more abundantly. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 10 says that in the Amplified, he has we're his workmanship prepared unto him for good works that we might live the good life. And God wants to show his kindness toward us through the riches of his grace. He wants to show his kindness toward us. Man, he wants to show how good he is. So in essence, we're supposed to live. We're not supposed to just spend our whole life laboring. Enjoy your life. There's a whole lot of believers don't go anywhere, don't do anything. I know believers haven't went 25 years old, never ventured 25 miles away from their hometown. But you have, you know, don't just watch the commercials on television seeing about the Sandals resorts and the Caribbean cruises and flying off to these remote places. You can go too. It's for you. So get your money together. That's why you're working, so you can enjoy your life. You're not just working to pay bills, man. Save something, set something aside so you can live. Don't just, you know, don't just slobber over somebody else having this beautiful car or this nice dress and so forth. You can have it too. So be encouraged and live. Find a way to make it happen for your life. Because when it's all over, when you see that obituary and it says 1948 to 2015, that dash in between there, all it is time. You got it? That's all you have is time. And this time is right now. So you have to make use of your time and live. Go to the beach. Go to the park. Go and just sit and watch the sunset. You know, let's say live on the West Coast or the East Coast. Watch the sunrise. You know, and live. Yes, get that car you always wanted. Why sit around, you know, the old commercial wishing you had a V8? You can have it. Yeah, you can have that house you want. Go for it. Trust God. This is believers from a biblical perspective. God wants you happy. Yes, he does. And if you're not happy, then go back to the drawing board and see, what am I doing wrong? Because this is not the life God wanted for you. Jesus came that we might have life and have it more abundantly. And my goodness, and that doesn't mean you have to go be all out in debt and everything to try to have fun. No, but you can schedule and you can plan and you can do it. And everything doesn't cost a lot of money either. You can enjoy a whole lot of simple pleasures, and you can dine at the fine dining restaurants as well. You can go to the events that you want to go to. You just have to set aside time, plan it, and do it. And then you'll look back in your life and you'll say, I have lived. I learned years ago, it is better to live and die than to die without ever living. And all, everybody's watched Shawshank Redemption, of course, when, said that, get busy living or get busy dying. And child of God, you need to get busy living. So you be encouraged today. Live, man. Go out there and have fun. Enjoy. Go get an ice cream right now and quit tripping on a little 2 pounds of weight. Go eat that ice cream and then go and get back on the treadmill. Enjoy this wonderful life. Hallelujah. This is BFABP.com here on YouTube. Believers from a biblical perspective. I'd like for you to click subscribe right now and just become a subscriber to BFABP.com and glean from some of these blogs that I put out monthly. And then also go to AnthonyBlackmanMinistries.com. AnthonyBlackmanMinistries.com, and that Blackman is spelled with a M-A-N, all right, .com. And then peruse some of the materials that I have available there. I'm just beginning to post some things that they'll be beneficial to your spiritual growth. Hallelujah. So do that in Jesus' name. Thank you so very much.